The book is a collection of sonnets, all rhyming and written mostly in iambic pentameter, and they're all about teaching and learning in some way. So the first sequence is about my years. I worked for a decade as a sick form English teacher. I left in 2012, and I think the passing of time allowed me to reflect on how profoundly teaching hundreds and hundreds of young people over those years had affected my thinking about all kinds of things. And the second sequence is a gathering of sonnets that are about teachers that I've had both formally and informally in my life. And the last sequence of poems is about my son learning to sort of negotiate contemporary London, and the way in which he's learning. The sonnet form is there because the poems are love poems to my students, to my teachers, and my boy. So it seemed like a fitting form. And of course, the sonnet is also the, you know, it's like at the pinnacle of high culture. And I was constantly having to teach the sonnet in my years as a teacher. So it seemed like an apt form for this book. I gathered poetry from my experience of teaching it, you know, I was teaching an anthology of 1,000 years of English poetry to 16-year-olds who were not that interested in poetry. And I think in my desperate efforts to enthuse them, I enthused myself. And that's when I began writing. So my life as a writer is intricately tied up with my life as a teacher as well. And I fell in love with the sonnet form through teaching it and also through writing it, because the tightness of that form, the levels of constraint that you're operating with, mean that you always have to be saying new things, pushing your imagination, reaching for a different image because you have to rhyme it. So that's where I was gathering the sonnets from. But also I was interested in experimentation with the sonnet form, because I always felt that if people would say, why are you writing in these kind of old fashioned, you know, male kind of canonical forms, I would say that you can't just throw the baby out with the bathwater when it comes to form. But if you've got something new to do with the sonnet, then that's what you should do. So I was particularly looking at Jeff Hilson's book, The Reality Book of Sonnets, where you've got everything from the, you know, sonnet with one word on a line, the visual sonnet that's got no words but 14 sort of paint strokes, and thinking that the sonnet is a place, a possibility, not restriction, ironically, you know. So I didn't come into poetry that late in life, but compared to other writers I know that were writing as teenagers, you know, I started writing in my late 20s, and I remember going at that time to the first T.S. Eliot Awards, and I just found it so glamorous. I mean, it's the Oscars of the poetry world, you know, and so exciting. And I've always gone to the awards, to the reading ceremony, and I've always read the collections that are on the shortlist, and it's always been a complete, you know, hope and a dream to get onto that list. So I'm so pleased, and also to be amongst the poets that are on the list as well, many of whom are friends, many of whom I know. So I feel like I'm in great company.